Hello, welcome to Rob 101, Computational Linear Algebra. This is an introduction to systems of linear equations. The objectives are to refresh your knowledge about systems of linear equations and set the stage for future things to come. We'll see some examples of systems of linear equations. We show there are three cases when there's a unique solution, there's no solution, and there are an infinite number of solutions. Let's look at an example here. We have a system of two linear equations. It's linear because we don't have any term like x squared, y cubed, cosine of x, sine of y, exponential of x, and so on. So that's why we call it systems of linear equations. To solve it, one idea is if we solve for x in terms of y, then we can substitute x in the second equation and we can solve for y then. And then if we substitute y back to this equation, we find the value of x. Of course, we could also solve for y in terms of x and then find the value of y, which you should try it on your own. Another idea is that we can add the second equation to the first one to eliminate y. In this case, we find the same answer, x equals 1. And then if we can go back and use any of the two equations, we get the same answer that y equals 3. In other words, the solution is unique. And x equals 1 and y equals 3 simultaneously satisfy our systems of linear equations. So the solution is unique. And we often stack the variables in a vector, an array that you see here. This means x equals 1 and y equals 3. Let's look into another example. In this case, there is no solution. We see that left-hand side of the second equation is twice of the first equation, but the right-hand side does not follow the same pattern, which of course makes it inconsistent. Now, if we follow the same idea, we solve for x in terms of y, and then we try to substitute it into the second equation, then we reach a contradiction, 2 equals minus 1, which is impossible. This shows that there is no solution for this system of equations. The second case, when there are an infinite number of solutions, is when we see the second equation is just twice of the first equation. There's a concept here that we will get to know it later in the course, and it's about linear independence. But for now, we just accept that the second one is twice of the first one, therefore, it's essentially the same equation. It should not change the answer to the problem. Now we try to solve this system of equations. We find x in terms of y. We substitute it into the second equation, and then we reach a conclusion that is perfectly fine. 2 equals 2, which is always true. This means the value of y is arbitrary, and y can take any value in the real line. So x equals y plus 1. We can write it also y equals x minus 1 and say x can take any value in the real line. So y equals x minus 1, it's a line in R2. You go ahead and plot this in a notebook for yourself. So this is a line with slope 1 and y-intercept minus 1. So to summarize, a set of two equations with two unknowns, x and y, with constants, these are the coefficients of x and y, and the right hand side, these are also constants, can have a unique solution, can have no solution, or an infinity of solutions.